हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू प्रशांत आईएएस। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द टॉपिक्स ऑफ एक्टिंग सीजेआई, एड हॉक जजेस ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड कोर्ट ऑफ रिकॉर्ड। एंड फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस क्लास वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन फर्दर। सो फ्रेंड्स, एज आई टोल्ड यू इन द लास्ट क्लास एंड एज यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन, द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज क्लास इज कंटेम्प्ट ऑफ कोर्ट। So friends, in this class, we will discuss about the topic of contempt of court in a very detailed manner. So friends, let's begin. So friends, the first and the most important question is that in which article of Indian Constitution contempt of court is given. So friends, as here we are discussing about the Constitution of India, so first of all, it is our basic duty to know that where this topic is given in the Constitution of India. So first of all, we need to know that where the concept of contempt of court is given in the Constitution of India. Or we can also say that in which article of the Indian Constitution contempt of court is given. So friends, here on the screen, I have written down two articles of the Indian Constitution. So this one is Article 129 of the Indian Constitution and this one is Article 215 of the Indian Constitution. So now let us read that what Article 129 and Article 215 says. So what Article 129 is saying, that Supreme Court to be a court of record. Okay, now let's read. So it is saying that the Supreme Court shall be a court of record, okay, and shall have all the powers of such a court, including the power to punish for contempt of itself. Okay, now let's read that what Article 215 is saying. So Article 215 is saying that High Courts to be court of record. Okay, now Article 215 is saying that every High Court shall be a court of record and shall have all the powers of such a court, including the power to punish for its contempt, okay, or for the contempt of itself. Now friends, by reading both of these articles, what conclusion can you draw? Okay, so I am asking you that what conclusion can you draw by reading both these articles? So if you will carefully read both these articles, then there are two keywords used in both of these articles. So the first keyword is court of record and the second keyword is power to punish for contempt of itself. Okay, here also you can see that, okay, so Article 129 is for Supreme Court and Article 215 is for High Courts. Okay, so in Article 215 also two keywords are used. The first keyword is court of record and the second keyword is power to punish for contempt of itself. Okay, so now when you will read both of these articles carefully, then you will come to the conclusion that what Article 129 is actually doing. So you can conclude that Article 129 is actually declaring that Supreme Court is the court of record. Okay, what Article 129 is declaring? Article 129 is first of all declaring that Supreme Court of India is the court of record. Okay, and then it is saying that Supreme Court of India will have all the powers of a court of record. Okay, and in the last class I told you that court of records, all the courts which are actually courts of records, these courts have the power to punish for their contempt. Okay, so then Article 129 is further saying that as all the courts of record enjoy the power, okay, to punish for the contempt of itself, similarly Supreme Court will also enjoy the power to punish someone for its contempt. Okay, so Article 129 is basically doing two things. The first thing which Article 129 is doing is that Article 129 is declaring that Supreme Court is the court of record. Supreme Court is the court of record. And the second thing which Article 129 is doing, that Article 129 is declaring that Supreme Court will have the power to punish someone for its contempt. Okay, means Supreme Court will have the contempt of court power. Okay. Now let us try to read that what Article 215 is saying. So friends, when you will carefully read Article 215 of the Indian Constitution, then you will come to know two conclusions. You will come to know about two things. द फर्स्ट थिंग विच आर्टिकल 215 इज डूइंग, दैट आर्टिकल 215 इज डिक्लेयरिंग दैट ऑल द हाई कोर्ट्स इन इंडिया आर एक्चुअली कोर्ट ऑफ रिकॉर्ड. ओके, सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट आर्टिकल 215 ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डिक्लेयर्स दैट ऑल द हाई कोर्ट्स इन इंडिया आर द कोर्ट ऑफ रिकॉर्ड. नाउ देन इट इज सेइंग दैट हाई कोर्ट्स विल एंजॉय द पावर विच इज एंजॉयड. ओके, सो हाई कोर्ट्स विल एंजॉय ऑल द पावर्स विच आर बेसिकली एंजॉयड बाय अ कोर्ट ऑफ रिकॉर्ड. ओके, एंड इन द लास्ट क्लास आई टोल्ड यू दैट अ कोर्ट ऑफ रिकॉर्ड एंजॉयज द पावर टू पनिश समवन फॉर इट्स कंटेम्प्ट. ओके, सो कैन यू रिमेंबर दैट इन द लास्ट क्लास आई टॉट यू अबाउट द टू फीचर्स ऑफ कोर्ट ऑफ रिकॉर्ड. सो द फर्स्ट फीचर वॉज दैट इट्स रिकॉर्ड शैल बी एडमिसेबल एज एविडेंस और रेफरेंस इन ऑल द कोर्ट्स ऑफ कंट्री. एंड द सेकेंड फीचर फॉर अ कोर्ट टू बी डिक्लेयर्ड एज अ कोर्ट ऑफ रिकॉर्ड इज दैट कोर्ट मस्ट एंजॉय कंटेम्प्ट ऑफ कोर्ट ज्यूरिस्डिक्शन. ओके, सो देन आर्टिकल 215 इज सेइंग दैट ऑल द हाई कोर्ट्स इन इंडिया will actually enjoy the contempt of court jurisdiction. Okay, means if someone will do the contempt of court, then High Court will have the power to punish that person. High Court will have the power to punish anyone for its contempt. Okay, High Court will have the power to punish someone for its contempt. Okay, so now friends, what conclusion can you make after reading Article 129 and Article 215. So, okay, so I have told you two things, that Article 129 is actually declaring Supreme Court as the court of record, and then it is giving contempt of court power, contempt of court jurisdiction to Supreme Court. Then Article 215 is declaring high courts as the court of record, and Article 215, the same article, this is giving contempt of court jurisdiction, the power of contempt of court to high courts. Okay, so now friends, what was our original question? So our original question was that in which article of the Indian constitution, in which article of the Indian constitution contempt of court power is given. So now you can easily answer this question. So now you can say that sir, contempt of court power is given under Article 129 and Article 215 of the Indian constitution. Article 129 gives contempt of court power to Supreme Court, and Article 215 gives contempt of court power to High Courts. Now friends, after this, the next important question is that what is contempt of court? Okay, so we can also say this like that, what is the meaning of contempt of court, or what is the definition of contempt of court? Okay, so whenever we are studying any topic, so first of all, it is our duty to know that where this topic is given, and then we should know that what is the meaning of that topic. What is the meaning of that topic? What is the definition of that topic? So as here we are studying about the contempt of court, so first now we need to know that what is the meaning of contempt of court, or what is the definition of contempt of court. So friends, the definition of contempt of court is given in Contempt of Court Act 1971. Okay, now what is this Contempt of Court Act 1971? So actually this is an act, or okay, so we can say that this is a type of law, this is a act, and this act was actually passed by the Parliament of India. Okay, so which authority passed this act? So this act was passed by the Parliament of India. So Contempt of Court Act 1971 is the act of Indian Parliament which actually defines the contempt of court, or which actually gives us the real meaning of contempt of court. Okay, so now friends, let's discuss in detail that what is actually given in this Contempt of Court Act 1971. So friends, Contempt of Court Act 1971, this act actually divides the contempt of court into two parts. Okay, so this actually separates or divides the contempt of court into two categories or two parts, and then accordingly it and then separately it defines both the types of contempt of court. So the first type of contempt of court is civil contempt. Okay, so according to the Act of 1971, the first, means according to Contempt of Court Act 1971, the first type of contempt of court is civil contempt. Okay, and after that the second type of contempt of court is criminal contempt. Okay, so now you will say that there are two types of contempts of court. The first contempt is called as civil contempt, and the second contempt is called as the criminal contempt. Now friends, we need to know that what is the meaning of civil contempt and what is the meaning of criminal contempt. So friends, for explaining you the concept of civil contempt and criminal contempt, I will take help from an example, and based on that example I will explain you the concepts. So first of all, I will explain you civil contempt, and then we will proceed to criminal contempt. Okay, so now I am reviewing this criminal contempt, and now we will discuss about civil contempt in a detailed manner. Okay, so let me write here on the board civil contempt. Okay, so now first of all, we are discussing about civil contempt. So now I am giving you one example, and based on that example, I will explain you that what actually is civil contempt. So friends, let's suppose that this is a person. Okay, so I am drawing the diagram of a person. I know this diagram is not good looking, but for the sake of understanding, just imagine that the name of this person is Mr. A. Okay, now I am drawing one more person on the screen, and let's suppose that the name of this person is Mr. B. Okay, name of this green person is Mr. B and this orange person is Mr. A. Now friends, let's suppose that Mr. A is a shopkeeper. Okay, so we can say that he is a shopkeeper, and what he sells electronic appliances. For example, he sells refrigerators. He actually sells refrigerators, TVs, televisions, electric heater, and let's say that electric speakers, washing machines, etc. Okay, so I think that all of you know that what actually are electronic appliances. Okay, and let's suppose that Mr. B is his customer. Okay, who is Mr. B? Mr. B is the customer. Now let's suppose what happened, that one day Mr. B decided to buy one television. Okay, and let's suppose that, okay, so what happened, that Mr. B along with his wife, okay, he went to the shop of Mr. A. Okay, and he told him that, sir, please show us some televisions. Okay, so then what happened, that Mr. A showed many televisions to Mr. B. Okay, and out of that, what happened, that the price of one television was 50,000 rupees. So Mr. B and his wife was actually very impressed after seeing the television whose price was 50,000 rupees. Okay, so what happened, that Mr. B decided to buy a television worth 50,000 rupees. So Mr. B actually bought the television whose worth was 50,000 rupees. But what happened, that when Mr. B returned to his home, and then when he opened the packet of television, and then he tried to turn on the television, then he found that television was actually dead. It was not working. It was a faulty piece. Okay, so what happened, that when Mr. B reached his home, so he found that the television was dead. So then what Mr. B will do? So you can put yourself in the place of Mr. B, and then you can think. So Mr. B then approached Mr. A and he said that, sir, your television is faulty. Kindly give my money back or give me a new piece. I have no problem, because actually I came to you to buy a television. So kindly, either you can give my money back, or give me a new piece of television. But Mr. A denied. Mr. A said that, no sir, this is our policy. Once a product is sold, then we will neither refund your money nor give you that new product. Now Mr. B was really worried. Now what happened, that there is one more person. So let's suppose this violet colored person is a person Mr. C. Now, Mr. C is an advocate. Who is Mr. C? Mr. C is an advocate. And he is the advocate in High Court. He is an High Court advocate. So, Mr. C suggested Mr. B that you should file a case in the High Court against Mr. A. Okay, now what happened? That Mr. B filed the case against Mr. A. Okay, what is happening? Mr. B filed the case against Mr. A in the High Court. And who is the lawyer? Lawyer is Mr. C. So now let's see what happened next. So friends, when Mr. B filed the case against Mr. A in the High Court, so now High Court came into action. Okay, so actually Mr. C was the lawyer. So Mr. C told High Court, means the judge of High Court, that, sir, actually my client, means Mr. B, has purchased a television from Mr. A, but this piece was faulty, and now he is not giving any refund to my client, nor he is giving a new piece to my client. So definitely it is a common sense. So even if you will think, then definitely you will give the judgment in the favor of Mr. B, because it was not his fault. So High Court also give the judgment in the favor of Mr. B, and High Court ordered Mr. A that now Mr. A will give 50,000 rupees in cash to Mr. B. Okay, what High Court ordered? High Court gave order. Now listen to my words carefully. That High Court gave order to Mr. A that he will return, okay, 50,000 rupees to Mr. B. Okay, means this shopkeeper will return 50,000 rupees to the customer. And the case was decided. But what happened? That 15 days passed, but Mr. A didn't give a single penny to Mr. B. Then what happened? 30 days passed. Then also he didn't give money to Mr. B. Then Mr. B said that when you will give my money, High Court gave the order that you should give my money back. Okay, so Mr. A this time denied that, okay, do anything what you can do, I will not give your money. So now Mr. B will again go to High Court, and now this time what is the case? Now this time the case is not between Mr. B and Mr. A. This time the case is that Mr. A has actually disobeyed the order of High Court. Mr. A has actually disobeyed the direction of High Court. High Court gave an order. High Court gave an order to Mr. A that give 50,000 rupees to Mr. B. High Court gave a direction to Mr. A that give 50,000 rupees to Mr. B. But what happened? That Mr. A denied to obey the order of High Court. Means he has disobeyed the High Court. Okay. So if Now I am telling you that what actually is civil contempt. So what actually happens in civil contempt? That when an individual willfully breaches an undertaking given to the court or willfully disobeys the direction or order of the court, that amounts to the civil contempt. Okay, so here Mr. A has actually done the civil contempt of High Court. Why? Because Mr. A has disobeyed the order of High Court willfully. Okay, Mr. A has disobeyed the order of High Court willfully. So civil contempt occurs when an individual willfully disobeys the order or direction given by High Court, or an individual willfully breaches or breaks the undertaking given to the court. Okay, I am again and again saying High Court because the in this example we are talking about High Court. Okay, but actually this is for, okay, but actually I want to say court. Okay, it can be Supreme Court also. Okay, so what is civil contempt? Now I will give you the definition of civil contempt. So friends, this is the definition or meaning of civil contempt. So when an individual willfully breaches an undertaking given to the court or willfully disobeys the direction or order of court, then it amounts to civil contempt. Okay, so what conclusion we can draw from definition? So for example, in our example, what happened? That Mr. A disobeyed the order. Mr. A willfully disobeyed the order of the court. Okay, so then it will be said that Mr. A has done the contempt of court. Okay, so now the court will punish Mr. A for its contempt. Okay, so definitely Mr. A will have to give 50,000 rupees to Mr. B because this was the order of court. But as Mr. A has done the contempt of court, so now he will get some punishment for this contempt also. So now High Court will punish Mr. A for its contempt also. Okay, so what is the meaning of this definition? So what happens that if any individual has disobeyed the direction or order of the court, then it will be said that he has actually committed contempt of court. Okay, civil contempt of court. So then definitely court will punish him. Now secondly, if an individual willfully breaches an undertaking given to the court. So now what is the meaning of undertaking? So undertaking basically means that, for example, if he has made some promise to the court, okay, or he has made some pledge in front of the court, or a kind of agreement. Okay, so let's suppose if an individual has made a promise in front of the court, and then what happens later on, he willfully breaks that promise. Okay, so if any individual has given some undertaking to the court and then later on he willfully breaks that undertaking, then it will also amount to the civil contempt of the court. And in both of these cases, the court will punish the individual for its contempt. So this is the meaning of civil contempt. Now friends, after this, let us move forward to criminal contempt. So again, I will explain you the concept of criminal contempt with the help of one example. So now let's suppose again, there is a person, okay, and the name of this person is, let's suppose, again the name of this person is Mr. A. Okay, So now let's suppose that this Mr. A is actually a leader. Okay, so he is a leader. Okay, and he has a good fan following in the public. Okay, and these are the people. And let's suppose he is giving some speech. Okay, so he is here standing on the podium, and this is the public who is sitting on the carpet. This is a carpet, and on this carpet the public is sitting. Okay, so there are many people present in the present to listen the speech. And what this person, and let's suppose that this is mic. So on this mic this person is giving a speech. Okay, so now what happened that in his speech, okay, in his speech what happened, now in his speech this person has said some words or something about a high court or supreme court, and these words, actually these words were trying to scandalize the image of court, or we can say that these words were trying to make the image of court bad. Okay, now let me use more simple language. So let's suppose that this person is giving speech, and what happened that this person used abusive words. Okay, so now you can relate more easily that this person used abusive words against High Court or Supreme Court. So what happened that in his speech this person used abusive words against High Court and Supreme Court. And definitely when this person will use abusive words against High Court or Supreme Court, then it will scandalize the image of court. Now these words can make the image of court bad in the eyes of these people. Okay, now let me take one more example. Now what happened that this person is giving a speech, and in his speech this person imposed fake charges on the court. Okay, let's suppose that this person imposed fake corruption charges on one high court. Okay, so are you understanding my point? I am saying that this is a leader. Okay, and he is giving speech to his followers, and in his speech he used some words. Okay, in his speech what he was trying to do, that he was trying to impose some fake corruption charges on the High Court or Supreme Court. And definitely you can think that when a person will try to impose fake charges of corruption on High Court and Supreme Court, then definitely this can scandalize the image of court. This can make the image of court bad. Okay, so now we will say that this person, okay, what was the name of this person? This person, Mr. A. Now this person has committed criminal contempt of the court. Okay, now we will say that this person, Mr. A, has committed the criminal contempt of the court. So now I think that with the help of these examples, you all must be clear that what actually is criminal contempt. Now I am giving you the definition of criminal contempt so that you all of you will become very clear about the meaning and definition of criminal contempt. So friends, I have written the definition of criminal contempt on the screen. So you can clearly read that the criminal contempt has been defined as the publication of any material or commissioning of an act that scandalizes the image of court or lowers the authority of court or attempts to interfere in the delivery of justice. So it basically means that if a person is publishing any material, so publishing any material means, for example, if you are publishing any article in the newspaper, or you are publishing any article in the magazine or anywhere else, okay, or commissioning of an act means you are doing anything. For example, I gave you the example that a leader was giving the speech. So he actually tried to scandalize the image of court in his speech. Okay, so if you are trying to publish any material, or if you are commissioning any act, and if your act or your material, if it can scandalize the image of court, scandalize the image of court means it can make the image of court bad, or it lowers the authority of court. Okay, means if you have said anything about court, if you have published anything about court, and your material has the potential to lower the authority of court, means it can lower the power of court. Okay, then also it will be called as criminal contempt, or it attempts to interfere in the delivery of justice. Now what does it mean? So let's suppose if there is some case in the High Court or Supreme Court. Okay, so let's suppose there is a case in the Supreme Court. Now let's suppose there are two parties in that case. party A and party B. Okay, means they can be two persons, Mr. A and Mr. B. Okay, now this case is between two persons, Mr. A and Mr. B. Now let's suppose that if there is a third person, let's suppose Mr. C. Now if this Mr. C is in the support of Mr. A, okay, and he knows that Mr. A is guilty, Mr. A is wrong. So he knows that there are very high chances that Supreme Court can give judgment in the favor of Mr. B. So now what Mr. C did, that Mr. C published the material in the newspaper, or he published an article in the newspaper in which he, what he is trying, that he is actually trying to pressurize the Supreme Court to give decision in the favor of Mr. A. Okay, or let's suppose he is making fake and false corruption charges on the court. Okay, means he is trying to pressurize the court. He is trying to interfere in the delivery of justice. Okay, so are you getting my point? So if any person is doing any of these things, means if a person is publishing any material, or if he is doing anything, and if his act or his material can scandalize the image of court, or his material or his act can lower the authority of court, or it attempts to interfere in the delivery of justice, then we will say that person has actually done the criminal contempt of the court, and definitely then court will punish that person for its criminal contempt. Okay, so for example, I gave you the example that here what happened, Mr. C was actually trying to interfere in the delivery of justice. Okay, so here Mr. C is actually doing the criminal contempt. So now Supreme Court will give punishment to Mr. C. So this is the meaning of criminal contempt. Now friends, after that what happened? That the Supreme Court of India clarified one thing regarding the Act of 1971. Okay, means the contempt of court 1971. So what Supreme Court of India said about the Contempt of Court Act 1971. So Supreme Court said that the Contempt of Court Act 1971 is not meant to protect the judges. Okay, what Supreme Court said? Supreme Court said this act does not gives the protection to judges, but this act is made to protect the seat of justice. Okay, now what does it mean when I am saying that the Act of 1971 is not protecting judges, but it is protecting the seat of justice? So it basically means that this act is not made to give any personal protection to the judges, but this act is made so that the justice can be delivered. This act is made so that nobody can interfere in the delivery of justice, so that nobody can interfere in the delivery of justice, so that justice can be delivered to all the people. Okay, why? Because justice is very, very important. So the Contempt of Court Act 1971 was not made to protect the judges, but it was made to protect the justice. It was made to protect the seat of justice. It was made so that nobody can interfere in the process of justice, in the delivery of justice. Okay, then after that, Supreme Court of India clarified that even if any judge is doing the contempt of court, then this judge can also be punished under Contempt of Court Act 1971. Okay, for example, if any judge is saying anything about the court which can scandalize the image of court, if any judge is publishing any material or is saying anything or doing any act which can actually lower the authority of court, okay, which can actually scandalize the image of court, or which can interfere in the delivery of justice, then this judge can also be punished under Contempt of Court Act 1971. So you need to keep in mind that even judges are not outside the scope of Contempt of Court Act. Okay, so contempt of court can even be filed against the judges. Why? Because Contempt of Court Act is to protect the seat of justice. It is not meant to protect the judges. Now friends, after this, the Parliament of India passed Contempt of Court Amendment Act 2006. Okay, so first of all, the act was passed in 1971, and after that, it was amended in 2006. So first of all, the question is that why Parliament passed the Contempt of Court Amendment Act? So the simple answer to this question is that the contempt of court power was being criticized. Okay, and due to its criticism, the parliament actually passed Contempt of Court Amendment Act 2006. Now what are the criticisms of contempt of court jurisdiction? This I can't tell you here because this is a open platform. So you can search on internet that what are the criticisms of contempt of court jurisdiction. So basically what I am telling you is that the contempt of court power was being largely criticized. Many scholars and many people were criticizing the power of contempt. Okay, means power, contempt of court jurisdiction power. Okay, so what happened that the Parliament of India passed Contempt of Court Amendment Act 2006 and some changes were brought in the earlier act. Okay, so now let's see that what are the provisions of this Contempt of Court Amendment Act 2006. So friends, majorly two changes were brought in the earlier act by the act of 2006. So let's see that what are these two changes. So the first is that no court shall impose a sentence under the act unless the court is satisfied that the alleged behavior substantially interfered in the delivery of justice. Okay. Now what does it mean? It means that the act of 2006 is saying that if there is a person, okay, so what Act of 2006 is saying? The Act of 2006 is saying that if a person is, or we can say that if the charges of contempt of court are imposed on this person. So let's suppose this is a person and the name of this person is Mr. A. And what happened? That there are the charges of contempt of court on this person. So now what the Act of 2006 is saying? So the Act of 2006 says that now court cannot give him punishment till the time court is satisfied, means till the time it is proved that his behavior, okay, means his act has actually interfered in the delivery of justice. Okay, so what the Act of 2006 is saying, that if there are charges of contempt of court on a person, okay, means if a person is charged for contempt of court, okay, then court will not give him punishment till the time court is satisfied that the behavior of this person or the act of this person has actually interfered in the delivery of justice. Okay, so it means that this act is trying to say that until it is not proved, okay, this act is giving direction to the court that court will not give punishment to the person who is charged for the contempt of court till the time it is proved or till the time the court is satisfied that his behavior has actually interfered in the delivery of justice. Okay. Now, what is the second point? So, the second change was that court must provide a chance to condemner to put his defense. Okay. So, it means that Act of 2006 is saying that let's suppose if there is a person. Okay. And let's suppose that the name of this person is Mr. A. Okay. Now, what happened that this Mr. A has said something about the court. Okay. Now, what court is saying that this person has tried to scandalize the image of court or this person has tried to interfere in the delivery of justice. Okay. So, what Act of 2006 is saying that court should not directly give punishment to this person. Okay. So, if there are charges of contempt of court on Mr. A, then court should not directly give punishment to Mr. A. First of all, court should give a chance to Mr. A to put his defense. Means Mr. A should also have a chance to defend himself in front of court. Okay. So there were two amendments majorly two amendments were done in the Act of 1971 by the Contempt of Court Amendment Act 2006. So what was the first amendment? So the first amendment was that court will not give punishment to the person who is charged for contempt of court till the time it is proved, till the time court is satisfied that the behavior of this person has substantially interfered in the delivery of justice. And the second amendment was that court should not directly give the punishment to the person on which there are the charges of contempt of court. First of all, court should give a chance to the condemner, means to the person, to put his defense. Okay, means this person should also give a chance to keep his point, that what was he actually trying to say. Okay, what were his intentions. So this person must also be given a chance to defend himself. So these were the two major amendments brought by the Act of 2006. So friends, that's all for today. I hope that all of you must have enjoyed the lecture, and if you have enjoyed the lecture, then please like the video, comment, subscribe the channel, press the bell icon and select all. Now friends, we will meet in next class with a fresh topic. Till then, stay indoors, stay healthy, take care of yourself. Thank you.